Okay, the latest on Operation Fast and Furious. This scandal is getting bigger by the day, and it should be getting bigger by the day because the ATF essentially got people killed. Now, they created an operation in which they encouraged U.S. gun dealers to sell guns to criminals so they could bring them across the border. We're talking about almost 2,000 guns here. They brought them across the border. They couldn't track them. They had no means of physically tracking these guns. People started to get killed in Mexico. And eventually, a U.S. Border Patrol agent, Brian Terry, ended up dead. He was killed. There were two of these guns at his crime scene. An epic screw-up. Well, there's reason to believe that they were trying to use this to make gun control change or gun policy changes. They're trying to justify some changes. Well, Eric Holder, Attorney General, he runs the Justice Department, which is really interesting, the Justice Department, right? And the ATF is a part of the Justice Department. He was in office as well as Obama when this operation was taken off. Now, there had been previous versions of this operation, wide receiver, with Bush. However, they had more control over what happened to the guns. With this operation, they just let them out. They had no real physical means of actually controlling delivery or anything. So Eric Holder has been held in contempt of Congress because he refused to turn over documents and more information about the whole situation. He's obviously hiding something. Obama ordered him not to hand over the information. Obama also used executive privilege to also hide whatever the heck they're trying to hide. And I think it's pretty obvious they're trying to hide something. Why else would you use executive privilege to prevent this information from getting out? Okay, now the Republicans and Democrats are bickering over some affidavits, some more information. So Eric Holder, the Attorney General, the guy who runs the Justice Department, refuses to cooperate in this investigation, which focuses on an operation that got people killed. It's interesting because at first, in May 2011, he claimed that, he only found out about this operation just a matter of weeks before, right? He testified before Congress and said it was new to him. However, we now know that in February and in March, there were emails between him and his number two guy at the Justice Department talking about how they're going to deal with this case, how they're going to deal with this whole scandal. So they obviously knew something about Operation Fast and Furious before that. We also have memos. He actually received a memo. Well, there was a memo sent out to Eric Holder. It was addressed to Eric Holder. It was talking about Operation Fast and Furious. It was talking about Phoenix. It's actually available online. You can check it out. He was actually briefed in July 2010. So this guy lied to Congress when he said, he just found out about this a matter of weeks ago. I mean, that's complete nonsense. So the guy committed perjury. The guy refuses to cooperate in this investigation. So I want to ask you guys, do you think this is the next Watergate? You know, whatever you think about Watergate or whatever, you know, this case actually got a lot of people killed. And it wasn't just the Border Patrol agent, Brian Terry. People in Mexico were killed because of these guns. They had no means of actually tracking them. So, Operation Fast and Furious. One of my predictions for this year is that it was going to become a bigger scandal. I don't know if this is going to result in anything big for the president. But it's looking bad by the day. They're obviously hiding something. So, you guys tell me what you think. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.